यस मैम।
सो रजिस्टर योर सेल्फ, ओके ऑल ऑफ यू, नॉट ओनली
ओके
सुमित,
मैम।
ऑल ऑफ यू विल रजिस्टर. Link, Udayan, you are saying the link, and link was given in the chat box. Now in this here. So it is showing to Obhijit. Otherwise, I will show the share the link in your group also. Register in Google form. Kanchan Sarkar.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so topic I will start today.
Quantum physics.
Quantum mechanics. Okay, quantum mechanics. I will start. This is the module four. This is in module four.
Ma'am. Ma'am.
So on. Say.
Ma'am.
Are I have yet not roll call. I have to call the names.
Ma'am, due to network issue, ma'am, I cannot join. For time.
Oh, in that seminar presentation.
Yes, ma'am.
So go through the link and register yourself for the science club, and for then different activities. I participate in different activities of the science club. All of you will join there and register yourself. Now calling the roll numbers. Roll number one.
Yes, ma'am.
Two.
Present, ma'am.
Three. 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 Roll number three absent. Roll number three present or absent? Okay. Roll number three is present. Four.
Present, ma'am.
Five.
Present, ma'am.
Six.
Present, ma'am.
Seven. Seven. Seven is present. Eight. Eight. Sharing screen is visible or not? Sharing screen is visible or not?
Yes,
visible, ma'am.
Okay. So today I'm starting quantum mechanics. So introduction to quantum mechanics and black body radiation. So first topic of quantum mechanics, black body radiation. Now the origin of quantum theory. First, I'm discussing about classical theory of physics. Classical theory of physics is based on some basic laws. First one is Newton's law of motion. Second one is gravitational law of attraction between two bodies. Third one is Coulomb's law of attraction or repulsion between two electrically charged bodies. And number four, Lorentz force equation on a moving charge particle passing through a magnetic field. So these are the points. But when The classical concepts were applied to the particles of atomic dimensions. Remember this one, the particles of atomic dimensions like electrons, protons, neutrons, nucleons, etc. They failed to explain the motion. So the classical laws, the classical theory, that is Newton's laws of motion, gravitational law of attraction between the two bodies, Coulomb's law, Lorentz force. So these are the from the classical theory of physics. But when the classical concepts, but these classical concepts were applied to the particles of atomic dimensions like electrons, protons and neutrons, electron, protons and neutrons or nucleons, etc., they failed to explain the motion. The failure of classical mechanics to explain the energy distribution of black body radiation put forward Max Planck to propose the quantum hypothesis. So Max Planck. The different properties of atomic dimensions particle, that is electron, proton, neutron and nucleons, to explain their motion, classical theory was not sufficient to explain. So here the classical theory was failed. Now this failure put forward Max Planck to propose quantum hypothesis. This was the origin of quantum theory. So this was the need for the quantum theory. Now next, the definitions. What is black body? So what is black body? Black body, the substance or a body which can absorb all the heat radiation of all wavelengths incident on it and does not transmit or reflect at all is known as perfect black body. So the body that can absorb all the heat radiation of all wavelengths, remember this one, all the heat radiation of all wavelengths incident on it and does not transmit or reflect at all is known as the perfect black body. A black body is a substance which can absorb radiations of all wavelengths incident on it and emits radiation of all wavelengths when it is heated. So remember this one, it emits radiation when it is heated, otherwise it will not emit any radiation. So black body substance can absorb radiation of all wavelengths incident on it and it only emits radiation if it is heated. It emits radiation of all wavelengths only when it is heated. So this is the definition of black body. Example, a perfect black body is an ideal concept. What are the examples? Lamp black, platinum black are almost perfect black bodies for practical purposes because they can absorb 95% of the incident radiation. So black body absorbs the incident radiation. So perfect black body, that is the ideal concept, but we can reach to the better approximation. So lamp black, platinum black are almost perfect black bodies for practical purposes because they can absorb 95% of the incident radiation. Now construction of black body and black body radiation. So this is the black body absorption black body. So this is the black body. Radiation is coming in this direction. There is one hole. So radiation is entering here. So now, this is the totally it is absorbed. Now emission black body, when the black body radiation emits, when the black body is heated, then black body radiation comes out of all wavelengths. It comes out when it is only heated. So this is the black body is the substance which can absorb radiation of all wavelengths incident on it and emits radiation of all wavelength when it is heated. So example is a lamp black, platinum black, and it is 95% it can absorb. Now the characteristics of black body radiation. First one is the energy density does not depend upon the energy densities means what? Energy radiated per unit area per second. This is the energy density. Does not depend upon the nature or shape of the walls of the enclosure. It depends upon the temperature of the enclosure. So in the previous slide, so this is the, if we think this container or this is the enclosure. So black body radiation depends on which? It depends on the temperature of the enclosure. Black body radiation depends on the temperature of the enclosure. And it does not depend upon the nature or shape or walls of the enclosure. So that does not depend on the shape of the enclosure. It only depends on the temperature. Radiation is isotropic in nature. Radiation are homogeneous in nature. All those are also emit black body radiation. So these are the characteristics of black body. Now Planck's hypothesis and radiation law. For example, the distribution of energy in the spectrum of a black body, Max Planck in 1900 established the quantum theory of radiation. So Max Planck explained the established the quantum theory of radiation. Now following these assumptions, first assumption was what? So Max Planck introduced the quantum theory, the idea of quantum theory. So some assumptions were taken at that time. What are the assumptions? First one is all bodies placed inside the enclosure can also emit black body radiation. Second is what? The atoms in the walls of the black body radiator behave like simple harmonic oscillators, and each has a characteristic frequency of oscillation. So atoms in the walls of the black body radiator behave like simple harmonic oscillators, and each has a characteristic frequency of oscillation. The oscillation of a black body, oscillator of a black body. So what is the oscillator? That is the atoms in the walls of the black body. So the atoms in the walls of the black body radiator behave like simple harmonic oscillator. So the atoms are the oscillator, simple harmonic oscillator. Where they are situated? They are situated at the walls of the black body. The oscillator of a black body has discrete energy, En. So oscillator of a black body has discrete energy, En. The oscillator of a black body has discrete energy, En. And what is this? The oscillator of a black body has a discrete energy, En equal to nh nu. En equal to nh nu. So the every atoms present in the wall of the black body has energy, discrete energy, that is En, that is nh nu. N may be 0, 1, 2, like this. And nu is the frequency of oscillation. The total energy of the oscillator is quantized. So you can see the energy, this is the energy expression. So if it is one value, then it is h nu. Then if it is two value, then it is 2h nu, then 3h nu, like this. But between 1h nu and 2h nu, you will not get any energy. That is 1.1h nu, 1.2 energy, 1.2 h nu, 1.3h nu, that is not possible. 1h nu, then next is 2h nu, then next is 3h nu. In between, no energy is possible. So it is said the total energy of the oscillator is quantized. Quantized means there is certain gap between the energy levels. The energy level is not continuous. Energy level is not continuous. It has discrete energy levels, or you can say it is quantized. Energy levels are quantized. Remember this one. The oscillators can radiate or absorb energy in quantas or packets of h nu. That is in discrete set of values. That is, I said already, that is 0 h nu, 2 h nu, in this way up to n h nu. Only when the oscillator jumps from one energy state to another. So it radiates energy when the oscillator jumps. Oscillator means here the atoms jumps from one energy state to another. So this is the Planck hypothesis. So this is the Planck's hypothesis and radiation law. Now, calculating the derivation. Now, this is the derivation. Calculating mean energy. There are n number of oscillators emitting energy only when the energy is integral multiple of some value epsilon. So, we are considering that there are n number of oscillators. That means n number of atoms are there emitting energy when only the energy is integral multiple of some value epsilon. So emitted energy of the oscillators, let it is 0 epsilon, 2 epsilon, 3 epsilon, like this. So these are the energies, energy by the oscillators. Now if we are considering nr is the number of oscillators emitting energy r epsilon. So R epsilon is the energy and NR is the number of oscillators emitting energy R epsilon. Then the total number of oscillator, what is this? Here we are considering the NR is the number of oscillator emitting energy R epsilon. So if it is here, if it is here, so the total number of oscillators, so inside the enclosure, what is the total number of oscillator? N0 plus N1 plus N2 plus in this way, NR plus dot dot in this way. So these are the total number of oscillator is N, and it is N0, N1, N2 and up to NR. So what is the total energy E that we are considering? The total energy is what? E N1, E epsilon N1. Plus 2N2 plus 3N3 plus up to in this way RNR plus in this way. So I have written the emitted energy by the oscillators, it is written in this way 0 epsilon, 2 epsilon, 3 epsilon, R epsilon. It is written in this sense. So the first one, N0. Plus N1 plus N2 plus N3, these are the number of oscillators. Then the total energy is what? Epsilon, then it is 2 epsilon, then the energy is 3 epsilon, then R epsilon, in this way it will go on. So it is epsilon, then 2 epsilon, then it is 3 epsilon, it is like this. And these are the number of oscillators, N1 plus N2 plus N3, in this way NR. So total energy, if we multiply epsilon with N1, you will get the total energy of N1 number of oscillators. If we multiply 2 epsilon with N2, that will be give the total energy by N2 number of oscillators. If I multiply epsilon with 3, that is 3 epsilon. If I multiply 3 epsilon with N3, it will give the total energy of N3 number of oscillators. Now taking the sum of all these things. So the total energy expression is this, and this is the total number of oscillators. Now from Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution, the probability of an oscillator to have energy epsilon, this is given by this. So this is the formula, this is the theory. It is the power epsilon by KBT. KB is what? KB is the Boltzmann constant. So this is the probability of an oscillator to have an energy epsilon. So this is the probability. Now for the RF oscillator, we can write NR equal to N0 e to the power minus R epsilon by KBT. So the total number of oscillator, so total number of oscillator, so it is the RF oscillator is NR. It may be N1, N2, N3, N4 like this. Many oscillators are there. So the number of oscillators, total number of oscillators N, that is I'm taking the summation R equal to 0 to infinity over NR. So this is the N is the total number of oscillator. And what is NR? NR is the RF oscillator. So I am taking the sum. Now total energy infinite GP series, we can write if energy E equal to what? So taking the summation over R equal to 0 to infinity. Epsilon R into NR. So this is the energy. So for NR, the energy is epsilon R NR. Now I am taking the sum. I am taking the sum over 0 to infinity. This is for one energy. For NR oscillator, the energy is this, E epsilon R NR, and taking the sum over 0 to infinity R. So this is the total energy. So total number of oscillator is N and the total energy is E. Then the number of oscillators. Then the number of oscillators, N equal to what? N0 summation over R equal to 0 to infinity e to the power R epsilon by KBT. So I have written this one from the previous slide. From this previous slide, I have written this. Now N equal to N0, this one, total number of oscillators, N equal to this. Now from here, we can calculate N equal to what? N0 by 1 minus e to the power minus epsilon by KBT. Now amount of energy is what? E equal to epsilon N0 summation over R equal to 0 to infinity R e to the power minus R epsilon by KBT. So from there, again, we can calculate the value of E. So what is the value of E? That is N0 epsilon e to the power minus epsilon by KBT divided by this. So we have the total amount of energy, the expression of total amount of energy, and also we have the expression of total number of oscillators. Now how we will get E nu, energy density? So if we have to divide E by N. So E by N we are calculating. So just divide this by this, then you will get E nu equal to epsilon by e to the power epsilon by kBT minus 1. So this is the expression of E nu. Now the Planck's law that we are deriving. Now energy epsilon equal to what? H nu. H is the Planck's constant. Now E nu, that is what? H nu by e to the power h nu by kBT minus 1. So see here, E nu. Already I have calculated E nu. E nu is what? E by N. Now you have written the value of E, then divided by N. So we have this. So we have E nu as epsilon by e to the power epsilon by kBT minus 1. And what is the value of epsilon? Say anyone? What is the value of epsilon? I just said energy equal to what? E equal to or epsilon equal to what?
H nu.
In terms of Planck's constant, H nu. So what I will write in place of H nu? What I will write? H nu divided by what? E to the power?
It's the epsilon.
Say not epsilon, epsilon is h nu. I'm just saying to put in the place of epsilon, what you will put?
H mu.
H nu. So here also put h nu. So e nu equal to what? H nu divided by e to the power h nu by kBT minus 1. So it is written here. E nu equal to h nu by e to the power h nu by kBT minus 1. Now energy density. It is written as E nu d nu. This is the energy density of radiation. What is this? 8 pi nu square by C cube E nu d nu. No need to derive this formula. Just write it energy. We know the energy density of radiation is this. E nu d nu equal to this. Then put the value of E nu from here to here. So if you put, you will get this expression. What is E nu d nu? This is 8 pi h nu cube by c cube d nu divided by 8 e to the power h nu by kBT minus 1. So this is the expression of Planck's law of radiation. E nu d nu, this is the energy density of radiation and this is the Planck's law of radiation. Now this is in terms of frequency nu. Now it is given in terms of wavelength. So wavelength, just convert that frequency in terms of wavelength, then I will get U lambda d lambda equal to 8 pi h c divided by lambda to the power 5, then d lambda e to the power h nu h c by lambda kBT minus 1. So this is your home task given. So what you will do, you will convert this nu to U lambda d lambda. Okay, so U nu d nu to E lambda d lambda. So this is the Planck's law of radiation. Now black body, a perfectly reflecting. So no need to go through these things. This is very given in detail. So if you can read, just go through it. If not possible, then leave it. Now come here. Energy density. So this portion, I will share in PPT. I will share the PPT. If you understand, then okay. And if not understanding, so I'm not discussing it because in PPT it is given in very detail. So this is the, if it is given, write down the Planck's law of radiation. So this is the U nu d nu in terms of frequency and U lambda d lambda in terms of wavelength. Now I'm coming here. What is this? Energy density. Energy density means what? Energy per unit volume for radiation frequency ranging from nu to nu plus d nu. Already I discussed this. So now energy density U nu equal to this. U nu d nu equal to this one. So if you eliminate d nu from both the side, so what you will get? 8 pi nu square by c cube E nu. Here E nu is the average energy of an oscillator emitting nu frequency. Now converting the same thing I have discussed, converting to wavelength, nu equal to c by lambda. So U lambda d lambda equal to, we can express it like this. Classical oscillator, now average energy, we can emit all possible frequency continuously. That is the difference between classical oscillator and quantum oscillator. Classical oscillator can emit all frequency of radiation continuously. That means no gap is there. But here it is different. Here for quantum oscillator, you will get discrete energy. Now here the equipartition theorem tells us a collection of oscillator, classical oscillator in thermal equilibrium at temperature T will have the energy kBT for each vibrational mode. So E nu equal to what? E lambda, that is equal to kBT. Now classical radiation energy density U lambda D lambda, what is this? This is 8 pi by lambda to the power 4 D lambda E lambda. Already I have derived this and we know that E lambda equal to kBT. So just put it here. So what you will get? U lambda D lambda equal to 8 pi by lambda to the power 4 kBT D lambda. So put it here in place of E lambda. You will get this. So U lambda, what is the expression? U lambda is 8 pi by lambda to the power 4 kBT. So this is the expression. Now Planck's radiation law. So Planck's radiation law is what? Already I have discussed. That is U nu D nu. That is equal to what? 8 pi nu square by C cube E nu D nu. And it is written like this. If we put the value of E nu and it is E nu D nu, this is the expression you will remember. It may be given in MCQ. Or write down the Planck's radiation law. 8 pi H nu cube by C cube D nu divided by e to the power h nu kBT minus 1. And I have derived this one. In terms of lambda, it is given U lambda D lambda. That is equal to 8 pi hc by lambda to the power 5 D lambda divided by this. So this is the Planck's law of radiation. And using this Planck's law of radiation, we can derive different laws of quantum mechanics. That is Wien's law, Wien's displacement law, Rayleigh-Jeans law. So these we can discuss. So Planck's radiation, from Planck's radiation law, we can deduce these expressions, these laws. So it is given. If it is offline exam, I don't know what type of exam you will have. Or if it is also short answer type question, you may have to prove that deduce Wien's law from Planck's radiation law, deduce Wien's displacement law from Planck's radiation law, and Rayleigh-Jeans law from Planck's radiation law. So remember this one. This is the energy density of radiation. Oh, black body radiation, energy density of black body radiation, it is given by this. So what I have discussed today, I have discussed what is black body radiation, the characteristics of black body radiation, Planck's hypothesis and radiation law, then with some figure of black body radiation and the derivation of the Planck's law, Planck's radiation law. What is the Planck's radiation law? It is given by this. This is E nu D nu equal to energy density of black body radiation. This is also the Planck's law. This is the energy density of black body radiation. This is E nu D nu equal to depending on this. The energy density of black body radiation is given by this E nu D nu. And in terms of lambda, it is given as U lambda D lambda. The Planck's law gives the energy density of black body radiation. So this is here. This is the energy density of black body radiation following the Planck's radiation law. Achha, tell anyone, if a black body absorbs the incident radiation, when it will emit the radiation, in which condition? A perfect black body can absorb all the radiation.
So when we heat.
When?
Heat.
When we heat the black body, the wavelength, all possible wavelength, radiation of all possible wavelength will come out of the black body. Okay, and this is the energy density of the black body radiation. Probably this is not given because this is very big derivation. Directly it may not be given, but if it is, it may be given. Write down the Planck's law. And this part is very important because the derivation of Planck's law you are I am doing here. Then another derivation of Planck's law is there in statistical mechanics also. And when we will discuss the statistical mechanics, then following the Bose-Einstein statistics, we will derive the same law. So Planck's law will be derived in two ways, from the quantum aspect and from the classical from the statistical aspect. From the statistical mechanics also we can derive. So after completion of the syllabus, if it is given the derived the Planck's law of radiation, then any process you can follow. If you follow the statistical mechanics process, then it is also okay. Now if it if you follow the quantum mechanical process, then also it is okay. But the law is the same, that is the u lambda d lambda in terms of lambda, 8 pi ac by lambda to the power 5 d lambda by to the power hc by lambda kbt minus 1. Kb is the Boltzmann constant. So this is the Planck's radiation law. Okay, so the time is over. I'm ending my lecture here. And next topic again I will discuss. I will derive different laws, that is Wien's displacement law, Rayleigh-Jeans law from the Planck's law of radiation. Directly prove the Planck's law of radiation, that is very long answer type question. 6 to 7 marks you will get for that if it is given. But generally it is not given. It is what is given, Wien's law, explain Wien's law, explain Rayleigh-Jeans law and derive this law from the Planck's law. This type of question is given. But you must have to remember the expression of the Planck's radiation law. You have to both remember, that is u nu d nu equal to this and u lambda d lambda equal to this. Just like you have two names at house, in house it, you are called by some name, and in your college say you have different name, but you are the same person. So here the same thing, u lambda and u nu d nu and u lambda d lambda are the two same, that is the same formula, one terms of in terms of here frequency and here in terms of wavelength. Okay, so ending my class here. And the next week I will give you the total marks. I will give you total marks. I will check the whole the class test paper here and I will share. Again, I will upload in Google Classroom. After checking, I will give. I will return the paper in Google Classroom. That is the edited paper checked by me. Understand? So leaving the meeting.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.